Good afternoon, everybody from Friendly Puerto Vallarta. It's a pleasure to introduce Meeting Incentive Experts President Amanda Nemeth, who will be taking us through a culinary journey today with renowned chef Thierry Blouet. Thierry has been a fundamental figure in the gastronomy of Mexico with three great restaurants: Café de Artis in Puerto Vallarta, an icon. Then we had Tuna Blanca in Punta de Mita, and more recently, Café de Artis Los Cabos at the JW Marriott. Thierry, thank you for joining us today. And I'm gonna turn over now to Amanda, who's gonna start the interview.
Excellent, thank you, Veronica. Thierry, it's so great to see you again, and it's an honor to have you with us today. So thank you so much for your time. Please give us a little bit of your background, your passion for Mexico, and your culinary history.
So my background starts with my parents, who my father used to be a general manager of hotels, as well as my grandfather. And because of that, we've been traveling a lot before I arrived to Mexico when I was 14 years old. My grandfather used to be the general manager of Georges V in Paris for 35 years and then in many of the greatest hotels of the world. Then my father, his first job as a general manager in hotels was in Puerto Rico, where I was born. And after a few, maybe 5-6 months to be in Puerto Rico, we moved to Venezuela, and then to Spain, then to France, then to New Caledonia in South Pacific, then to Australia, then to France, and then finally to Mexico. So I've been traveling a lot, living in hotels most of the time, and always I had this connection with the hospitality since I was born. I was born in a hotel, and always hospitality. For me, for Mexico, is really a big passion. What I do in my kitchen and in my restaurants is really a fusion of all the French techniques, all the French savoir-faire of good cooking, good life, and with all the fantastic flavors, ingredients, colors of Mexico. When I discovered Mexico, it was for me, after being traveling as a kid in many, many countries, arriving to Mexico was like, wow. That's the place I want to stay, and so what I do is really a mix between my French culture and my Mexican culture, because now I'm also Mexican. Now I have the Mexican passport, and Mexico is for me now my first country. Now is Mexico. So what I do is this balance between the two cultures, France and Mexico.
Excellent. And how long have you been in Mexico now?
So now for 40, I arrived with my parents 41 years ago.
Fantastic. Well, truly a very international array of experience you bring to your tables, and for those of us fortunate enough to have experienced that, we know exactly what that means. Wonderful. Can you tell us about the International Gourmet Festival that takes place in Puerto Vallarta that you have helped co-found?
Well, yes, I start this with a friend of mine from Switzerland, that lives in Mexico for big part of his life also. And he used to be chef, then general manager, then he has his own restaurant. I'm talking about Heinz Reise. And we get together 26 years ago. What could we do he at that time he was a general manager of Crystal Hotel, and at that time I was with Café des Artistes, maybe just 4 years. I just started Café des Artistes. Café des Artistes is going to be 30 years now in December. 30 years. And so we were talking, what could we apport to Puerto Vallarta? What could we do to Puerto Vallarta? At that time, it was not like now. It was quite slow, but growing quite fast. And we wanted to do something for Puerto Vallarta. And we decided we could do something like a small festival. Just we decided we're going to try this for 1 year. And there is jazz festival, mariachi festival, but nothing about fishing, the fishing tournament. Not many things were going on in the city at that time. And we decided, let's put together a few restaurants, a few hotels. We can invite some guest chef and cook together a big dinner. And each chef cook as a guest chef in the hotel, and the restaurant is going to be invited. Great idea. We got little sponsoring to do little publicity. And we start with four hotels and four restaurants. Now we are around 25 to 30 participants between hotels and restaurants. Normally it's like half and half between Riviera Nayarit and Puerto Vallarta. So we are in the whole bay. And so we have sometimes more than 30 guest chefs coming from all around Mexico and all around the world. So every day we have a fantastic program with different events every day. We have the big inauguration, that's the big event for 500, 600, or 700 people, where all the guest chefs are together and cook. Like you see in the wine shows in the United States, where all the chefs cook a tapa, and you have all the wineries with the wine, we have live music, we have the sponsors, so it's like a big, it finished like a big party, and we present all the guest chefs officially. So that's the big, big event. And then every day we have cooking classes, wine tastings, special night chefs in one place, in another place. And at the same time, every chef is cooking in every hotel and restaurant. So as a guest, when you come to Puerto Vallarta, at that time of normally it's the last, it's just the week before Thanksgiving. And when you come to Puerto Vallarta at that time, you could go for dinner in 28 different places. So it's a lot of going on. And we have a lot of fun organizing all this. That makes Puerto Vallarta and Riviera Nayarit much more stronger in the all the gourmet scene. So I think that's one of the greatest things that could happen. And also to put together hotels and restaurants to work together, to do something together.
Absolutely. Well, there's no doubt it is a very important event for the destination, and the culinary experience in Puerto Vallarta is unlike any other. That is absolutely true. Speaking about restaurants in particular, and the three restaurants that you have, can you give us some insight into what you're doing as far as safe practices and social distancing as you think about reopening, both for the individual segment and then also for our group segment?
Well, yes, we are. We are. It's very sad we cannot open again. We decide to close the restaurants for 3 months, planning to open in July. I was planning to open the 1st of July. That's going to be 3 months we are closed. And if not, we'll move to the 15th of July. And we are working in all the, of course, all the safety. You have to do the distance, not only this. Now, all the hotels are working very hard in all the system, since the employees, they get into the restaurant, they get disinfected, they check the temperature, they have to clean the shoes, the hands, change clothes. Now we are working, we are looking with a company who disinfected all the restaurants. They do this, I think, once every 2 weeks, but very, very, very hard. That helps to maintain no virus inside the restaurant. And also, we're going to have half of the tables out. So one table yes, one no. And for the guests who arrive to the restaurant, we need to check them that they have no temperature, they clean their hands, that they are not sick. And in case some are, we cannot let them in. And so we are right now working on all these systems for cafes artists. We're going to do same way, same style as hotels are doing it. And we will start as soon as we open. For groups, at the moment, we're going to do the self-distance, separate all the tables. Because for groups, that's the main thing, no? If we take half of the restaurants out, so we're going to do smaller groups. And that's no problem. But as soon as we can put the tables as we used to have, we'll do it. But we'll wait that it's allowed to. Now we're going to do the half of the restaurant is going to be out, and we're going to do everything we has to be done to receive our guests in a safe way, and also to all our employees. We want them to be safe at Café des Artistes and to Nabla.
Absolutely. Yes. And it's very important we all follow those same protocols. We are also doing the same. And as we see things slowly getting back to normal, once flights are starting to come back and the capacities, come to back to each destination, that will definitely change things. But in the meantime, the social distancing, minimized capacities, I think is something everyone is looking at right now, especially in the dining scene. It's important, and we'll just have to follow that until things change and we see what happens. But we really appreciate all the wonderful information you've given us today. Thank you for sharing so much your love for cooking and your love for hospitality. I think we can all agree friendly Puerto Vallarta is one of the most friendliest and wonderful places in Mexico for true hospitality. And we all look forward to being back there as soon as we can and seeing you at Café des Artistes, Terry. Thank you so much.
Thank you. It's really a pleasure to be with you and to enjoy this all this good time we're having right now. And don't forget, Puerto Vallarta is more beautiful than ever. I have 33 years living in Puerto Vallarta, and I never saw Puerto Vallarta so beautiful as now. It's incredible, but it's true. So all the first guests who come to Puerto Vallarta will discover a new Puerto Vallarta.
Absolutely. Excellent. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Gracias.
Gracias. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Gracias.